You've probably caught a fish, seen one on a plate, or scrolled past one with a hook in its mouth. But did you ever ask yourself if fish can actually feel pain? Or are they just some flopping meat robots? Sounds like a simple question, but three major scientific studies are in disagreement. And what they say might just ruin fishing trips and sushi nights forever. What if I told you fish might feel pain like humans do, but they can't say it? First things first, what is pain? If we want to answer if fish can feel it, we first need to understand what it is. And there are two layers. First is nociception, which is the automatic body reaction to danger, like pulling your hand off a hot stove. It has already been demonstrated that fish do this. They are capable of nociception. They can detect threats and have a reflex response. And the second layer is the actual pain, the conscious emotional feeling that makes you say, if fish do or do not experience pain, scientists are yet to confirm. So far, a fish pulling away from a hook might just be reacting automatically, or it might feel the pain. Specialist takes are opposed on this matter. In a research published in 2002, Dr. James Rose explains that awareness of pain in humans depends on functions of specific regions in cerebral cortex, and fishes lack these essential brain regions, making it untenable that they can experience pain. He's basically saying that the neocortex, the human pain center, is absent in fish. No neocortex, no pain. But if fish can't feel pain, why do they act like they do? Let's look at another research from 2003. To study whether fish don't just react from reflex but actually feel the pain, Dr. Lynne Sneddon has injected a noxious chemical into the lips of rainbow trout. What happened next? The fish rubbed their mouths, refused to eat, and acted weirdly. And when she gave them morphine, they calmed down and went back to normal. Painkillers working on fish? It no longer seems like they can't feel the pain. Meanwhile, the team of Victoria Braithwaite, one of the key scientists working on fish pain, showed trout can even learn to avoid places where they got zapped before, which takes more than reflex. It takes memory, decision-making, and maybe even fear. So again, if fish are just reacting, why do they remember pain? Let's see what really goes on inside a fish brain. It's true, fish don't have a neocortex like us, but they do have a structure called the pallium, which might work in similar ways. They also show emotional reactions, fast breathing, darting, hiding, and their stress hormone, cortisol, spikes under pain. So brain signals check, hormonal response check, behavioral change check. Things look pretty clear to me. How are scientists still arguing about this? Here's where it gets heated. In the first study I cited, Dr. James Rose says that awareness of pain in humans depends on specific regions of the cerebral cortex. Fishes lack these brain regions and thus lack the neural requirements necessary for pain experience. But in her research, Dr. Victoria Braithwaite found that fish have A-delta and C-fibers, the same pain nerves we have. Plus, their brain shows signs of emotional processing. And after her experiment, Dr. Lynne Sneddon also concluded that the behaviors fish displayed after being injected with noxious stimulus are not simple reflexes, and these behavioral changes are similar to some of the pain-related responses of higher vertebrates. While Rose claims that these are misinterpretations, that no neocortex means no consciousness and no pain, anatomy, behavior, and chemistry all seem to be pointing to fish possibly feeling pain. It's like watching scientists fighting in a trout duel. Let's bring this home. If fish can feel pain, that changes how we treat them. From fishing and farming to cooking and research, everything changes. Inhuman slaughter methods show fish in full panic, flapping, spitting, crashing into walls. Some don't die instantly, they suffocate slowly. If they are feeling pain, it's kind of horrifying. And if they aren't feeling pain, no harm done by being careful. I'm asking you, if there's a 1% chance fish feel pain, shouldn't we act like it's 100%? I'll let you think about it. Let's wrap it up now. Do fish feel pain? According to Dr. Rose, probably not. According to Dr. Braithwaite and Dr. Sneddon, most likely yes. Science doesn't have a final answer yet. So your belief is up to you. Let me know in the comments, do you believe fish feel pain? And would that change anything? Smash the like button if this gave you something to think about, and subscribe for more fact-checked insights about our oceans.